In 1996, genetically modified foods were first allowed into our food supply in America.
The GMO machine has been extraordinarily effective in squelching the conversation.
The biggest problem with genetically modified organisms or genetically engineered foods is that we don't know the long-term outcome.
And to show how strong the agenda is, how could anyone argue against at least labeling foods GMO? If they have nothing to hide, if GMOs are safe and effective or propose any threat to individuals who consume them, why would you be worried about putting it on the label of the food that you sell?
There's something that seems kind of sneaky about people manufacturing food and researching it and engineering it and marketing to us, and for some reason or other, they don't want to tell us what's in it. I find that odd. I know that if you buy, you know, a shirt or a pair of pants, it has to say that it's, you know, 90% cotton and 10% lycra. So I want to know what's in my food if I know what's in my pants.
We have supposedly some parts of our government that are designated to protect our interests. These people are paid with our tax dollars to safeguard our well-being in these realms. Yet, it's not happening. So now let's look at the FDA. Let's look at the FTC. Let's look at our regulators.
I think it's because most of the FDA and EPA and USDA are infiltrated with appointed very high-level executives that came from the biotech industry.
It's the wealth of the force behind the GMO initiative that's causing this to occur. What's for sale? It can be bought. The hearts and minds of the culture and the compulsion to force them into behaviors can be bought.
So we have a huge challenge on our hands to re-educate people from the top down and from the bottom up. You know, from their gut and from their head.
The reality is there are other countries who have said no to GMOs. They've looked at it and said, this is disturbing, there's not enough evidence, we've made a choice not to do this, but we're supposed to be in the United States, the land of the free, where those types of things don't happen. But this is such a issue as far as saying this is scary, this is disturbing, this is unknown, that other countries who technically might be less free as far as individual rights are concerned are saying no to GMOs until there's more data, yet here we say yes. It's indefensible. Obviously there is something to hide. Obviously there is a concern. Obviously they think that individual consumers, given the choice, would prefer not to buy that food. So what is their solution? Don't let them know they're buying that food. That, to me, as I feel even the hairs in the back of my neck standing up, is evil personified.
What I would like to say to the biotech industry and the food industry is stop messing with my children's health, with my husband's health, with my family's health. Enough is enough. Let's go back to real food, conventional farming without GMOs, and taking care of the people and putting the people first, not profits.